whenever you are doing the transaction, there are a lot of tables involved. Okay, so let's say, for example, if I'm trying to make a simple accounting document, so we have a BKPF table for header, BSIC table for line, BSIS for index, Peggle FlexP for the totals. So a single transaction, it is like updating more than 10 tables in the background. And obviously, if I want to create a report now, so I have to pick the information from different tables. Okay, so even a small report, if I want to write, let's say you are a functional consultant and we are required to create a functional specification on a day-to-day basis. So what we do, we go to the main table, we pick some information, then we go to the second, third, and we need to create those runs. Okay, so this is again a kind of a challenge, because if all the data is stored at one single place, we can avoid this different tables completely. Right, so yes, that is one point. Any other point that comes to your mind? Yes, Prashant.
Yeah, hi. There will be a lot of changes even in the server setup also compared to EHP and EC6 version.
Mm-hmm. What exactly you mean by server setup?
I just heard and I just read through that there's a lot of difference between the RAM, that's the random access memory, in S4HANA compared to the general ECC servers RAM. Actually, it's much of compressed, pretty fast, and it can be used by the retailers in a very flexible way, and less of clearances actually required.
Okay, so in short, you are saying that in SAP ECC, one of the problem was the way in which the data was stored in the database, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, so you are actually talking about the benefit of SAP HANA, but let's talk about the challenges. So challenge was that the way in which the data was stored in the database was again complicated. Okay, so yes, you are correct. So what we were doing is, let's say if we take any example of any older database that we were using. So we were using Oracle, we were using Sybase, we were using, let's say, SQL. So all these databases, because they were developed around 30 years back, okay, and they follow the concept of storing the data in the hard disk. Okay, so you must be aware that there are two forms of data storage. One is your hard disk and second is RAM. We are going to talk about these things in detail, but I'm just giving you the that the, in short, if you want to keep it very simple, let's understand in this way, the speed was a major concern in SAP ECC. We will go into more technicalities later on, but just to summarize this, the speed was one of the issue, one of the challenge with the traditional ECC system. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
What else? What about the way in which the user interfaces? Yes, Amit.
Yeah. So, Gaurav, actually, see, when you talk about the multiple thing, not only for finance, but the major is like universal general entry, that is single source of the truth. That is the main advantage of the S4HANA.
About advantage, we are talking. We need to
challenges.
Yeah. Okay. But you are right. See, if you talk about the challenge is there are different components in SAP. FI is a separate component. CO is a separate component. Then you have a lot of different components like COPA. So each and every component of SAP is using their own set of tables. And what is happening is there are a lot of chances that whatever is updated in FI is not properly updated in CO. And at the end of the month, we need to perform a lot of reconciliation activities, right? So that is something which is correct. Like in SAP ECC, we are facing the challenges to reconcile. Now again, this reconciliation problem, if you are working on new GL accounting, this reconciliation problem is rare. But if you are working on classic GL accounting, there are a lot of issues in performing the reconciliations. But yes, this is again one of the pain points, because each and every component is independent and there are chances that something is updated properly in FI and that is not properly updated in CO or COPA. So that is another challenge. Okay, let me now summarize.
So very, very common one is, again, we can talk about RRI, because that is also a challenge, right? Because with the new setup, it will give you the more advantage and the more benefit by using the RAR, right? Revenue accounting and reporting.
Okay. See, RAR is a completely different thing. RAR is something which, anyways, even now in SAP S/4HANA, RAR is coming as a separate component. Okay, but we'll talk about that. Okay, so just to summarize, let me take these 3-4 points from here. The first pain point is the speed. Okay, the way in which we are generating the reports, customers are always complaining that it takes a lot of time to generate the reports. Right. Second pain point is for us as a functional consultant, whenever we are required to create a new report, we need to pick the data from different tables. We need to create those joins. So what is happening is the data model, which is called as a data model, is very complex. Data model is the way in which the data is stored in the tables is very complex. There are a lot of tables. You need to remember all those tables. You need to create a joins. And that is the reason, that is one of the reason why our reportings are slow. Okay, and third, obviously, from if I talk from the FI point of view, let me frame this as a slower closure. Okay, so what is closure? FI closure. So normally at every period end, our accountants are required to close their books. Okay, which means they will, yeah, monthly activities. They perform a lot of reconciliation activities, they generate a lot of reports. But because of a lot of manual activities that they need to do at the month end, and because of this reconciliation issues, the closure is normally not happening on time. Okay, so normally you must be knowing that by 5th of every month, you should be able to close your books. But practically speaking, there are a lot of companies who are not even able to close their books by the 10th of the month. Now, what is the reason? If you ask the end users why you are not able to close the books, they will give you the simple reason that my FI and CO is not reconciling, or my manual activities are that much that I need to pass the data from here to there, and then only I can generate the report. Okay, so in short, you're closing the report. Even bank reconciliation, yes. So according to Akash, even bank reconciliation is an issue. So I'm not going to bank or PR or AP, just one thing, reconciliation is always an issue at the month. Okay, so that is something which is another pain point in SAP EC. And fourth point which nobody has identified is these screens. The screens that we are using, you must be aware that this transaction codes, let's say for example, if I want to create a vendor invoice, I'm going through this 360 transaction, and there are a lot of fields there. Okay, so just take a simple example. If a new person is joining your organization, to give you the training on that particular screen is very difficult, because everybody nowadays, even a small software company, is coming with apps. You can use on your mobile device without providing anything. But when it comes to SAP, the screens are so complicated that a new user will find it very difficult to work on SAP system. Okay, so why that is a challenge? Why not we can make it simple that even the users can access their mobile devices or tabs and perform the transactions? That was another challenge on SAP ECC, and the customers were again and again asking SAP, can you provide us simpler screens which can be accessed from any device and we can be able to do the transactions in much faster way? Okay, so this was number four. Let me talk about number five, which is for the companies who wants to implement SAP. So let's say there is a company who is interested in implementing ERP. Now there are a lot of ERP vendors available in the market. SAP is definitely the major ERP vendor, but still there are a lot of other options available. So the problem with SAP was, if you are using SAP ECC, before you implement SAP software, you need to buy a lot of hardware. Okay, and which is kind of a very huge infrastructure cost required initially in the project lifecycle. Okay, and that is where there were a lot of customers who were deciding to go away with SAP, away from SAP, and going with someone who is providing the hardware on cloud. So take an example of Salesforce, take an example of another ERP vendors who are providing the hardware on cloud, which means companies don't need to invest that much amount in hardware, they can only concentrate on the software content. Okay, so that is another challenge. SAP ECC was never available on cloud, or at least SAP ECC with traditional database was not available on cloud. Okay, so this was just some of the points so that we can make this session more interesting. So let me now go to SAP ECC picture. This is how exactly SAP ECC will look like. So in the center, you can see it consists of SAP ERP. Okay, what exactly is SAP ERP? SAP ERP is a central component that you are using. Okay, on top of SAP ERP, there are some customers who are using SAP CRM, SAP SRM, SAP PLM, SAP SCM. Okay, these are just examples. There can be more number of components which are outside your SAP ERP box. Okay, so what is SAP ERP? SAP ERP is a central component which consists of the core modules. Like your MM, your SD, your FI, your CO, they come in the ERP. Okay, but apart from that, the components like CRM, SRM, SCM, PLM, you can see in this particular picture, those are not coming under the core component. Those are available as a separate component which requires the interface. Right. Now the question is, why SAP provided these components like CRM, SRM and all these other ones as a separate component? Why not they are built inside the main ERP itself, like the core modules? Okay, can you just try to answer this? My question is, if SAP has provided all the modules like MM, SD, PP, there are a lot of modules, right, within the core component, then why CRM, SRM, PLM, SCM and all different modules which are not the part of the core component? What is that reason? Why they are also not embedded within the same component?
Yeah, because those are the additional functionality come into the picture later, because based on the customer experience, right? Like a GATP kind of one example.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because eventually when they started using this SAP ERP, and then the customer they understand the requirement or the new advantage of the system, and that's the reason like SAP come up with those, all the SAP SRM, PLM, SCM, and CRM. So those are the additional functionality.
So, but if we go with that definition, let's say when SAP started this R2, see that was the whole reason of showing you this picture. So when SAP started with SAP R2, why they came up with R3 within the same component? Okay, so when we are talking about R3, let's say R2 was only having...
Yeah, so R2 was only for the two layer, right? And the R3 was the three layer.
Mm-hmm. No, that is okay, Sunil. My question is, in R2, let's say there were only two modules, payroll and finance. Okay, and in R3, there was payroll, finance, MM, SD, and other modules. Again, in ERP, there were more number of modules. Then my question is, if till 2004, SAP was bringing this functionality within the core component itself, why after this ERP, they started to bring these functionalities externally? Why not within the same ERP product? You got my point now?
Yeah, this is Amit. So, you know, in my opinion, that these are the separate component, not earlier owned by SAP, but later on, because lots of the other users were already using PLM, CRM, SRM on a standalone basis. So SAP allowed them to integrate with the, you know, to bring those customers who are not working on SAP, but they were using the CRM or SRM. So SAP allowed them to integrate with the with additional component within SAP, so that the customers can easily start using SAP, as well as they can keep continuing this SRM or CRM components with their using earlier.
Okay, yes, that is one of the good answer. So according to Amit is saying SAP SRM CRM components can be also used independently. So for example, if a customer who is not using SAP ERP can also use SRM CRM just on top of their existing ERP. So that is also correct. But other way to look into this is SAP ERP was already loaded with lot of components. Okay. And if we keep on, let's say for example, today, if SAP says, okay, CRM, SRM, we will bring on the same ERP component. SAP ERP is, we already understood, right? We started the session like this, that the major problem in SAP ECC is the speed. And if we bring SRM, CRM, APO, everything in the ERP itself, the speed will even go down, right? And that is the reason SAP thought of bringing these new components, new functionalities separately. to reduce the load on the main ERP component. Okay, so this is another way of looking into it. So SAP ERP contains already a lot of components which are already making it very slow. And if you keep on moving, if you keep on adding more and more features into the same ERP product, definitely at one point of time, SAP ERP will not be, like, the speed will be the problem and nobody would be able to on SAP ERP system. That is the reason they came up with this different components. Okay, so again,
you are saying only for the performance. That was the major the important point, right? The performance.
Yes, exactly. So okay. Another way, Amit also said correctly, because SAP is also being used, SAP SRM CRM is also being used by companies who are using SAP as an ERP. But still, the main idea of coming up with this SRM CRM separately was to make sure that, the load on the main ERP comes up. Okay? So performance, yes, performance is one thing that SAP was thinking about, and that is the reason they brought this component external. So the customers who want to use it, they have to use it external. Okay, so just understand this performance issue. Now I'll talk about why there is a performance issue at the first place. So we already understood SAP ERP is a performance issue. We will now try to understand why there was a performance issue. What are the components, what are the architectural problems due to which there were performance issues in SAP ERP. Okay, let's go through the next slide. So just to summarize whatever we have discussed till now, we are dividing the challenges into two parts. Challenges from IT perspective. IT perspective means your IT department. Now consider a company, let's say manufacturing company. There are business users and there are IT users. IT users are the users who are maintaining the IT. So for example, if you are implementing SAP system, your basis team, your hardware maintenance team, these are the IT users. Okay, so what are the problems with the IT, and then we will understand what are the problems with the end users, business users. So if you go through this list, the first point is big data explosion. We all know big data. Okay, if you don't know, let me just tell you in one point what is big data. So just understand like this. If you go back 10 years, okay, if you just go back by 10 years, let's say in 2005, 2007, how much of data you were storing on your mobile devices?
Yeah, in MBs, it was very less.
Maybe in KBs or MBs, right? Today, it is like even on your mobile devices, you are storing GBs of memory. Okay, and that too, one person has more than one mobile. So just to take an example, if you include all the data that you have in your social media, in your computer, in your laptop, in your mobile devices, so one person is having several GBs of data. Okay, so you can understand by this way, how many GBs of data is available in the system. So for example, now I will try to relate this example with SAP. So just take a simple example. Again, if you go back to 2005, 2007, who were the companies who were using SAP? Mainly bigger manufacturing companies. Okay, and they were selling the products in bulk. So for example, let's take an example of a company, manufacturing company. They are getting the orders from the customers, and each order have thousands of quantities. Okay, so those were the customers who were using SAP. So less number of sales orders in a day, let's say total quantity that they were selling is 10,000, but they were getting only 20, 25 orders, each order of more than 500,000 quantity. Okay, so the number of sales orders were minimum, around 25 to 30 orders in a day. So if you talk about the SAP tables, there was not much of data in the SAP tables. If you go to the sales order table, around 25 to 30 orders per day. Now you think, what is the current trend? The current trend is even the who is actually selling to the consumers now, because earlier the consumers were buying from the retailers. Retailers were buying from the wholesalers. Wholesalers were buying from the manufacturers. But now, mostly because everything is buying online, the consumer is directly ignoring the third parties in between. And even there are a lot of customers who are using SAP and they are selling one unit at a time. Okay, so for example, if you are going for Amazon, if you are going for Flipkart, you are purchasing a single quantity from them. So just understand, in order to sell that 10,000, 20,000 quantities, they are creating thousands of orders in a day. So this tells us how much data in SAP system the customers are storing. So 20, 25 orders per day to thousands of orders in a day. So what is happening? The data is increasing day by day. Okay, so that is nothing but big data explosion. And that is the reason there are a lot of theories which are going on big data, how to reduce the amount of data, how to make the meaningful insights of the data. So these are the challenges in SAP also, not only to the other technologies. Even in SAP, customer wants to know what is important data, how can I make the insights out of that? How can I take the decisions based on the data which is stored in my SAP system? Okay, so that is a challenge for IT. How to make sure that the important data is segregated from the data which is no more required. Second is Internet of Things. Every company today is expecting automation, right? So I'll give you the practical example. One of our customers, see, normally we know we do the good receipt for per purchase order. Okay, so whenever a good receipt is done, you have a team who is doing the good receipt in the system. But one of my customer, they implemented a system where as soon as the material is received into the factory, they kept the sensors and automatically GRNs will be done. Okay, so these are just some examples of Internet of Things, automation of the process. They don't want the users to enter those transactions manually. Those will be done automatically. Even you might have already heard, and many of the companies are already using this Miro process automatically. So they just scan and everything is done automatically. Okay, so that is something which is also the Internet of Things. Now, this type of things, they were not there 10, 15 years back. They are all coming now. Okay, so that is another thing which IT want to implement. See, CIO of your company is always burdened with lot of new requirements from the business. Okay, so CIOs, what is the main key performance indicator of CIO of your company? To make sure most things are done automatically. Okay, so in order to support that particular requirement from the business users, they need to think about how can we improve our SAP system. Instead of just struggling to get the reports, how can we make sure that we are getting more advanced reports from SAP? Okay, so that is something which is problem with IT. And obviously multiple servers. If you just go with this example, how many servers do you need? Just go with this example. So one ERP system, separate system for SRM, separate system for CRM, separate for PLM and separate for SCM. So at least if you just go with this picture, you need five different hardware systems on which these five components will be installed. So you need to maintain multiple servers. And traditional ETL system. Any idea what is ETL? Very commonly used in SAP, ETL. If you used BWBI something, so you must be aware of what is ETL. Anyone who can answer what is ETL? It is extraction, transform, and load. Okay, I'll give you the example, maybe the some of the other slides.
Yeah, it's a testing tool, right? It's a testing tool.
No, not a testing tool. It is, you can see here, the left-hand side picture. So what is happening here? You have a transactional system where you are doing the transactions. Okay, and you are doing, let's say you are doing the reporting in BW. So you have a ECC system and you have a BW system. What you do normally, you do your transactions in ECC. Whatever transactions you are doing, you will be doing in ECC. And your reports, you will be getting in BW. So in order to get the reports in BW, you need to extract the data from ECC, transform it, and load into BW. So that is extraction, transform, and load. So what is happening currently, because you are not able to generate your reports directly into your main system, in the core system, you are only able to generate the reports like the Excel reports and all, but you cannot generate the graphical reports in ECC. If you want to see those graphical reports, you have to go for BW. And if you are going for BW, you have to follow this ETL system. So what is the problem with the IT? They need to extract the data from ECC. They need to transform that data and they need to send that data to BW. Now, I am not saying they are doing it manually. It might be done automatically, but still, their purpose is to make sure that all the systems are ready, all the data is coming from, every day the data is getting picked from your ECC and it is going to your EWC. It is a time-consuming job, right? And obviously, with all this information, the hardware cost is huge. Because I just gave you the example, there are multiple servers you are maintaining. You need to extract the data. So these are all time-consuming activities. These are all money-consuming activities. So ultimately, the big IT challenge for SAP customers who are already using SAP ECC system is huge hardware cost. Okay, so this is from the IT perspective. Now coming to the business users, maybe before I go ahead, any questions till now? Let me know if you think I'm going fast, you can stop me and you can ask the questions.
No, we are good, thanks.
Okay. Purva, are you able to understand Amit?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, then let's go to the next slide. Now let's talk about the challenges from the business perspective. What do you mean by business perspective? These are the end users who are using SAP on a day-to-day basis. So first of all, complex user interface. As I told you, they are not happy with the screens. Any new person who is joining the organization, he takes around 15-20 days at least to get him comfortable with the screens, right? Because otherwise he will do a lot of errors. There are hundreds of fields. We need to tell him these fields are required, these fields are not required. Okay, so that is the complex user interface. Slower transaction and slower reporting, we already discussed about the performance. Okay, so the speed is obviously one of the issue. We'll talk about why speed is an issue, but we all agree that speed in SAP is an issue. Outdated reports. So just now we understood one concept of ETL. Let's say your manager wants to see graphical reports. Okay, so now in order to get these graphical reports, we need to extract the data from ECC. We need to load that data into BW. And normally it is done once in a week, once in a month. Okay, it is not done on the daily basis. And even if you are doing on the daily basis, it will be done only at the day 8. So next morning, if somebody wants to see the report, we'll be only able to see the data which is 1 day old, or 1 week old, or 1 month old, right? So in short, the reports which are available in our SAP system, those are outdated reports. We don't have real-time insights. And finally, as we discussed, the need of reconciliation. Because FI is a separate component, CO is a separate component. FI uses its own set of tables, CO uses its own set of tables. So it is very much possible that some information is correct in FI, but it is not coming same in CO. And you need to invest a lot of time at the month end. The end users are not able to generate their reports on time because the figures are not matching in FICO. I'm just giving the example of FICO. It is not necessarily FICO. It can be any other component also, like material ledger, like asset accounting, COPA. So these are basically the five components which are using the separate set of tables as of today. Okay. So these are some of the challenges which are faced by the end users who are actually using SAP system. Okay, so now how exactly SAP S/4HANA will solve this challenge? So we will come to the detailed S/4HANA discussion later on. But as of now, just remember SAP S/4HANA is the product which is delivered by SAP to remove the challenges which we discussed just now. So in short, I will just summarize what are the benefits of SAP S/4HANA. First one, it will provide you speed. How we will discuss. First one, it will provide you the speed with the help of SAP HANA database. Now, according to SAP, SAP HANA database is faster and it will provide you the performance. How, why SAP HANA is faster? What is the architectural layer of SAP HANA? That is something which we are going to discuss in detail. So first one, SAP HANA or SAP S/4HANA performs better compared to traditional ECC system. Second, it provides you new user screens. So you don't need to worry about the older screens which were not very good for the end users to perform the transactions. So that is something which will also be simplified. Third one is simplified processes. When we say simplified processes, it means the reconciliation issues that we were discussing about. So reconciliation problems will go away. Users will get real-time reports with the help of simplified financial processes. Okay, and the last point, if you see, choice of deployment. So as I told you, one of the challenge with SAP ECC was a customer who wants to go for SAP, he has to purchase the hardware. Okay, but now when it comes to SAP S/4HANA, customer has a choice whether they want to purchase the hardware or they want to buy the hardware on rent, which is cloud-based subscription. We will talk about what is on-premise, what is cloud in detail, but as of now, just remember these 4 points, which are the benefits of SAP S/4HANA. So the first one is speed, second one is user interface, third one is choice of deployment, and fourth one is simplified financial processes, which will reduce the reconciliation activity completely. Okay, any question?
No. Yeah.
No question. Okay. So now let's proceed towards our first point, first benefit, that is the speed. So again and again, we are saying SAP S/4HANA will provide the better speed. The question is how and using what. So SAP HANA or SAP S/4HANA will provide the speed with the use of SAP HANA database. Okay, we will come to these points later on. Let me talk about SAP HANA now. Now, before I go ahead and talk about SAP HANA, I just want to understand from your side, how many of you remember what exactly is the difference between SAP HANA and SAP S/4HANA? Or is it one and the same thing? Is there any difference between SAP HANA and S/4HANA, or it is same thing?
Both are different because in ECS is the different tables and HANA is all VSEG and BKP, all the tables are merged in HANA.
No, but you are talking about the difference between ECC and HANA. I'm talking about the difference between HANA and S/4HANA.
No.
Any idea what is the difference between HANA and S/4HANA?
So HANA is a database, right? Which is used for the S4. The S4 is application, right?
Exactly. So HANA is a database and S/4HANA is an application which is built upon HANA database.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other answer? This was correct answer, Sunil. Absolutely correct. Any other thing which you want to add, Prashant?
Yeah. See, there's even simple finance in S/4HANA. It's a part of it. But again, it's a functional stuff, and there's again HANA is completely database.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, and something, yes. There are some exclusive things only for simple finance, which is part of the SAP HANA database itself.
Not exactly. Okay, I'll clarify that. Yeah, thing.
Something like asset accounting, there's a complete drastic change in a simple finance compared to the classical whatever is for assignment. Because I'm from functional side.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. There are changes, but the question here is HANA versus S/4HANA. So you answered it correctly. HANA is a database and SAP S/4HANA is an application which has the simplified processes.
Yes.
Any other answer anyone wants to add here? Purva, you were answering something? Cannot hear you, Purva. Okay, no problem. Any other answers? You want to add something? Okay, no problem. Let me clarify. So SAP HANA is a database and SAP S/4HANA is an application. Just to give you the example, let me just show you this particular thing in Excel. So just give me a minute. How can I open another one? Okay, let me go here and then view. Okay. So when you were using SAP ECC, what was SAP ECC? Is it an application or is it a database?
Application.
SAP ECC is an application, right?
Yeah.
So was there any database for SAP ECC or no database?
No, there is a database, but that was a separate. Either you can go with Oracle, MS SQL or something, the third party vendor database.
Exactly. So database is always there. Any software that you are using, it has two parts, front end and back end. So this is called as front end. Front end is a screen that you are able to see, and database is a back end. Mm-hmm. Okay, so back end is something which is used to store the data in the background. So whenever you do any transactions, the screens are application related. So the screens are designed in SAP ECC, but whenever you save that, whenever you change, whenever you delete, whenever you insert, data will reside in the database. Okay, so in SAP ECC, SAP was using the databases like Oracle or maybe Sybase or maybe SQL. Okay, so there are a lot of databases which SAP was supporting till now. And these were all third-party databases, because SAP don't have their own database till 2011. Okay, so before 2011, SAP was totally dependent on third-party databases. SAP was just an application. Whenever a customer wants to implement SAP, they can decide whether they want to go for Oracle database or SQL database or any other database. Okay, so SAP ECC was an application, and these were the databases. Now, when we are talking about SAP S/4HANA, SAP S/4HANA is what? Application or a database?
Means application.
It's an application, right?
Yeah.
Application. So what about database? Are we going to use Oracle, Sybase, SQL?
No, only HANA actually.
So now SAP is very clear. SAP will not allow any third-party databases with S/4HANA. The only database which is available is SAP HANA database. So which means, when you were using SAP ECC, there were a lot of options when it comes to the database. But when you are using SAP S/4HANA, only option of database is SAP HANA. No other database can be used. And even the name. Okay, so what came first? SAP HANA database or SAP S/4HANA application?
Only HANA actually.
HANA came first.
Yeah.
Okay, and that is the reason the name of the application is SAP S/4HANA, which means the application which will run only on HANA database. Okay, so the name itself, SAP S/4HANA, is given because it means the application which is developed based on SAP HANA database. Okay, so which means whenever you are using SAP S/4HANA application, in the background there must be HANA database. No other databases are supported. Okay, I'll just ask you one simple thing, just to avoid the confusion. I know everybody understood this very well, but I will just share one story which you will be able to understand what is the basic difference between HANA and S/4HANA. So I met one of my friend and I asked him, which SAP version are you working on? And he said, I am working on SAP S/4HANA. Okay, so I just asked him, okay, within SAP S/4HANA, which is the version that you are working on? Because in SAP S/4HANA, if I talk from on-premise point of view, we have these versions. It started with 1511, then came 1610, then came 1709, then came 1809. Okay, so in case of on-premise, these are the only four versions which are available as of today. So I was expecting the answer either 1511, 1610, 1709 or 1809. His answer was, we are using EHP 8. Okay. So again, my question was, if you are using EHP 8, how it can be S/4HANA? You are using EHP 8, it should be ECC. It is not S/4HANA, right? His answer was, we are using EHP 8 application on HANA database. Okay, so first of all, just want to know from you, is it possible? Can we have SAP EHP 8 application running on SAP HANA database? Yes, possible or not?
Yes.
It is possible, right? SAP HANA can be used on ECC also. So starting from EHP 7, and EHP 8, which is a new latest version on ECC, both these applications can run on SAP HANA database. So there are some customers who are running EHP 7, EHP 8 on HANA database. So the question is,
they are not using S4 application.
They are not using S4 application, right? So in that case, whether he was correct or wrong, that he is working on SAP S4 HANA.
Yes.
Correct.
Yeah.
So this particular is S4 HANA, you mean to say?
Only for the database, not for the application.
No, but he said I am working on SAP S4 HANA. So his point was correct or wrong?
No.
S4 is like no wrong.
His answer was completely wrong, right? Because he was saying he is working on SAP S4 HANA. S4 HANA is not a database. SAP HANA is a database. If he says I'm working on SAP HANA database, we can understand it. But he's saying SAP S4 HANA. SAP S4 HANA is not on EHP 7, EHP 8. SAP S4 HANA is an application. So he might be working on SAP HANA database, but still the application that he's using is SAP ECC only. Right? So I just want to make sure that you understand the difference between, it is not necessary that if you are using SAP HANA database means you are using S4 HANA application. SAP HANA can be used for ECC as well as S4 HANA. It application decides whether you are on ECC or S4. Okay, I hope now you will be very much clear with the basic difference between HANA and S4 HANA. HANA is completely different thing, S4 HANA is completely different thing. Correct?
Yes.
Any question on this point?
No.
Okay. So let's go through this detail into this topic that we just started. Now, if I ask you the simple thing, you must have heard that in SAP S4 HANA, there are only few tables. Okay, so for example, I'm going to talk about this in detail, but I'm just giving you the example. There is a new table called as AC.A in SAP S4 HANA. So my question is, if I go with SAP HANA database, will this application consist of AC.A or not?
No.
Will you find AC.A in EHP 7, 8 on HANA database or not?
Not found.
The answer is no. Because these tables are added on the application, not on the database. If you go with SAP HANA database, there are definitely some benefits of SAP HANA when it comes to speed. But when it comes to the table level changes, you will not find any table level changes if you are going just with HANA database. Okay, see why I'm putting the focus on these points is even in the market, there is a lot of confusion on these topics. Okay, so if you just go to the customer, I'm just sharing the real time examples what I faced. If you go to the customer and if you ask them, you just upgrade your database to SAP HANA, the first question you ask, it will change my database, it will change my tables. Answer is definitely no. Your tables structure will only get changed when you go for S4 HANA. Just by going to HANA database will not affect your table structure. Your tables will remain as it is. Okay? Any questions on this? Any confusions on this? The difference between HANA and S4 HANA?
You'll be training on which version actually? You'll be training on which version actually? It's a 18 or 17.9, how is it?
No, we are going to have this 18.09.
Okay.
Yeah, this training is going to be on 18.09.
Okay.
Okay, so no confusion on HANA and S4 HANA? Can we go further?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, let me just remove this now and talk about something new. So now
only we can say the AC.A is a part of the application. It's not part of the database.
Exactly. AC.A is a part of application. It's not coming with the HANA database. It is coming only with S4 HANA application.
So what happened in the ECC? Like suppose when say the MARA table, right? So unless and until we don't have the MM module, so the MARA will not be part of the any Oracle database or the SQL database, or in that case, everything will be, all table will be part of the database without the application or no?
No. S4 HANA application, when we are talking about S4 HANA application, it consists of all the modules, not only finance. It consists of all the right. modules. So Mara is very much part of S/4HANA also.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So when you install the application, all the tables will come. That's what I'm saying, right?
Yes. Definitely. Okay. All the tables will come, but only see again. All the tables means only the tables which are available. So for example, there are a lot of tables which are no more available in S/4HANA. So those tables.
Finance is a good example. Only we'll see the ACDoc only. We'll not see the other old table.
Yes. So finance is, if you go with the finance example, you will find ACDoc a new table. There are a lot of other tables which you will not find. If you talk from MM or maybe logistics area, there is a new table called as METDOC, MedDoc. Okay, so that is something which you will only find in S/4HANA. You will not find in SAP ECC.
Correct, yeah.
Okay. So just to summarize and go further with HANA, what we understood till now is in ECC, I'm just entering the very important things here. In ECC, the challenges are speed, or you can call it the performance. Okay, the second thing is the user interface is very complicated. Third thing is the hardware cost, or maybe no cloud option. I can say no cloud option is provided. And fourth important thing that we just now discussed is need of reconciliation. Okay, and now when we are talking about SAP S/4HANA, we are talking about all these challenges will go away. Okay, so first thing is how the speed will be tackled. So faster speed, this will provide you faster speed. This will provide you new user interface. Okay, I'm going point by point. So here the challenge was speed. Here the speed is faster. Here the challenge was user interface. Here you got a new user interface. Here there was no cloud. Here you have the option of cloud. Here there was a reconciliation issue. There is no need of reconciliation. Okay, so these are the benefits. Now we will talk about how these things are possible in S/4HANA. So we will take one by one. So faster speed because of SAP HANA database. Why SAP S/4HANA is a faster database? Why SAP S/4HANA is faster? It is because our traditional SAP ECC system was using third-party databases. And all those third-party databases were developed around 30 years back, because of which there were a lot of performance issues. SAP HANA is a new database which was only developed in 2011. This was only released in 2011, which is making the use of latest technologies. What technologies we will talk about? So SAP HANA will provide you speed. What about new user interface? How this is possible? So this is possible with something called as SAP Fiori. So SAP Fiori is providing you the user interface. Again, we have one separate session on SAP Fiori where we will be discussing how SAP Fiori is better compared to the traditional GUI. This provides you cloud. I think no explanation required. The cloud, we'll talk about that. And no need of reconciliation because of simplified processes. Okay, so there are some processes which are simplified, which are integrated. So in short, in this course, we are going to talk about the overview of SAP HANA. Overview means we are not going to be technically into database, how the table is created, how it is deleted, how it is changed. That thing we don't need to worry about because we are the functional consultants. Those things will be taken care of by bases and other guys, right? So SAP HANA, we will be just talking about the overview. Overview in the sense you will understand why SAP HANA is faster. What is in-memory computing? What is column-based data storage? That things we will discuss just now. SAP Fiori, again, it has nothing to do with the functionality. So this is also going to be overview because, again, SAP Fiori will be taken care by, it is a new skill nowadays, SAP Fiori consultants. They are part of ABAP or they are part of even basis consultant. There are some basis consultants who are also entering SAP Fiori nowadays. Okay, but most importantly, as a functional consultant, we need to spare more and more time on this simplified processes. So we are going to talk about this in detail. So this topic we'll be talking in detail. So before we go into the detailed topic on simplified processes, our initial 3-4 sessions will be discussing on this too, and there are more topics which are part of S4HANA. Okay, which will be just an overview. So now let's focus on SAP HANA. I hope you understood the difference between HANA and S/4HANA. Now let's talk about SAP HANA. Again, before we talk about SAP HANA, why exactly we need SAP HANA? If simple question, if anyone is asking you why SAP HANA, it is just for better speed and performance. Simple. Why HANA? Better speed and better performance. Now the question comes, how SAP HANA is providing you better speed and better performance? So what was that which was not possible in traditional databases? So let's talk about challenges in traditional DB. What are these traditional DBs? These traditional DBs can be Oracle, it can be Sybase, it can be DB2, it can be SQL, it can be anything. Okay, you can keep on adding the list, whatever databases were supported. So now what were the challenges in these traditional databases? The first thing is they were all developed around 30 years back. So I'm not saying there are no changes, then there are no new versions, but still the architecture is still the same that was developed 30 years back. So for example, they were storing the data in hard disk. Okay, so let me now talk about this particular point in detail. Okay, what do you mean by storing the data in hard disk? What is the other option? Do we have any other option? So if you just take a simple example, in your laptop, there are two kinds of memory. You can say laptop, you can say mobile device. There are two kinds of memories. What are those?
One is a RAM.
RAM and ROM, you might have heard. So RAM is random access memory. And ROM is read-only. Okay, so normally we ROM is also called as hard disk. Okay, so there can be different ways. It is not only hard disk, but let's focus on this hard disk. So can you tell me what is the difference between the two? If you just take a simple example.
Yeah, one is a volatile and one is a non-volatile.
Okay, yes. Volatile means once it is switched off, everything goes
Yes.
Yes. Okay. But otherwise, what are the differences? Let's say, what are the main important features of RAM and ROM? Do we need both or one is sufficient? Both are required, right?
Yes. So one is for the
Yes. Let's say if you are buying the mobile, you will look for more RAM or more ROM?
That's RAM actually.
You will only look for RAM? Okay, let's say you are getting the mobile for 32 GB of RAM. Okay, but when it comes to ROM, it is only giving you 4 GB, or maybe even 4 GB is too much. Let's say 1 GB. So will you buy that mobile?
We need to again add space actually.
Sorry, Pradhan?
Any memory stick would add on.
Okay, but even if you are adding the memory stick, let's say you are adding the memory stick, that is also the ROM, right? Why do we need? If you don't do this, in that case, what would be the problem?
Yeah, it's better to have both better actually.
You need both, right? I'll tell you why.
Yeah, it's slower, right? Yeah, we need.
Better RAM, if you have 32 GB of RAM, definitely your processes will run faster. Okay, so you'll be able to do whatever apps you want to use, they will run very fast. But when you try to save a song, when you try to save a video, you will always get a message that your ROM is full. Okay, so this is nothing but secondary storage. This is actually storage. So normally we go with memory and RAM. So RAM is how the speed of the mobile will work, and this is how much you can store on the device. So what was happening till now, in SAP also, we have this RAM and ROM. We have this RAM and the main memory. Okay, sorry, RAM and the hard disk. So till now, this RAM was minimum. Let's say if you have 1 TB of data in the hard disk, I'm just taking the example, even I'm not sure about how much RAM should be enough. Let's say 10 GB of RAM, just for example's sake. Now, this 10 GB is only required to make your SAP system executable. Okay, so means faster. When it comes to storing the data, we are always storing the data in the hard disk. Okay, so let's take a simple example. You are trying to book a vendor invoice. Okay, you are trying to book a vendor invoice and you are using this transaction FB60. Now, using this transaction, when you click on save button, okay, so whenever you are in this transaction FB60, the speed at which you can roam around with the fields, that depends upon how much RAM you have. Okay, but as soon as you click on save, it will go and decide hard disk. Okay, so now if you are storing the data in the hard disk, let's say your BSEC table, BKPF table, all are residing in hard disk. Now, when you try to perform the reports, every time you have to go to the hard disk to get the data. So let me take this simple example, how exactly it will work. So you are asking for data. So select star means all the records from table BKPF. So in short, you are trying to get the data from BKPF table. So this query will first go to RAM, because RAM is something which is making it possible to execute anything in the system. So whenever you give any instruction to the system, it will first go to RAM. From RAM, it will go to hard disk. It will pick the data, again it will come to RAM, and then it will be available to the user. So every time, whenever you are performing any report, the data through RAM, it is going to hard disk, and the data is coming back from hard disk through RAM to the user. So this is just like an example. There are three rooms. You are sitting in this room, okay, and you want to fetch something from this room. So unnecessarily, you have to go from here, this passing by this room, and bring the data again, pass by this room. It would be definitely better if that thing is available here itself. So you can save time to go to hard disk and collect the data. And that is exactly what SAP HANA is doing. SAP HANA, they put the logic, they change the entire description of RAM and ROM. So RAM was only treated to execute the process, but the data was only stored in hard disk. Now with the concept of SAP HANA, they are storing the data in the RAM. Okay, they are making the use of the latest technology available called as in-memory computing. What is in-memory computing? In-memory computing means, instead of storing the data in the hard disk, which is very old technology which we learned in the schools and colleges, now there are more and more databases which are directly storing the data in the RAM. Okay, so you don't need to fetch the data from the place which is too far away. You can fetch the data which is immediately available. Okay, so that is RAM. So this is called as in-memory computing. In-memory computing means, instead of storing the data in the hard disk, data will be directly available in the RAM. Any question on this? This is called as in-memory computing. So this is first benefit of SAP HANA database. So what was the problem? The first problem that we identified with our Oracle database is the data was stored in the hard disk. And how SAP HANA is making it possible, how HANA is making it better, because it stores the data in the RAM. It stores the data in the RAM, and that is the reason it is called as in-memory database. Any question on this point? I am 100% sure you may have heard this terminology again and again, in-memory computing, RAM. Okay, but now are you sure, are you confident to answer what is in-memory computing and what is the difference between RAM and ROM? Any question? Do you want 5 or 10 minutes break before we continue?
No, we can go ahead.
Go ahead. Are you sure? It should not happen that I'm speaking and everybody's tired.
No. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so any questions till now before we go ahead to the next one, which is another benefit of SAP HANA. So this is the first one, is the data is stored directly in RAM. Any questions?
No.
Okay, let me ask one by one. Sandeep, any question? Ujay?
Gaurav, Sandeep here.
Yes, Sandeep.
So, in this concept, in-memory computing concept, so like, do we have any relationship with the OLTP and OLAP concept?
Yes. We'll talk about OLTP and OLAP. So, in short, means reporting and the transactions. Okay. So, Sandeep, that point is. Okay. We are going to talk about that point.
Okay, Gaurav. Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, so let's go through the next point now. In-memory computing. The second one is row-based data storage versus column-based data storage. Okay, again, in order to explain this too, I have to go in 1970s, where we discussed that SAP was having this version, SAP R2, then SAP R3, then we had SAP ERP, and now we have SAP S4HANA, application is S4HANA. Okay, so when R2 was developed, if we already discussed that there were only few modules, let's say FI and payroll. These were the only two modules. Okay, so let's say in FI, so these are, I'm just writing here the versions or applications. These are the modules which are available, and these are number of tables. And this is number of fields per table. Okay, so just for example, I'm not going to write exact number of fields. I'm just trying to explain you the concept. So when SAP R2 was launched, let's say there were only FI and payroll module. Okay, and very few number of tables, let's say overall around 50 tables. That is also too much, but let's say overall around 50 tables, and each table has around, let's say, 12 to 15 columns. Okay. Then came SAP R3, where apart from FI, there were logistics also. There was, let's say, logistics. So FI as well as logistics. So the number of tables increased from 50 to, let's say, 500. Okay. And every table, let's say, have the data of around fields of around maybe 200 to 300. Okay, on the average, or maybe I'm considering only the tables with maximum number of fields. Okay, so maximum number of fields in a table is around 200, 300 when it comes to R3. Then came SAP ERP, which is not only FI and logistics. It also includes your concepts like, let's go with FSCM, okay? Let's go with advanced WM, okay, WM and all. Again, this is just an example.
CRM, SRM.
Number of tables has moved from 500 to, let's say, around 2000 tables. Okay, and again, there was a need that we need to have around 500 columns in the table. Okay, so let's say, S4 I'll come later. Let's say this is a picture as of now. So what was happening? SAP R2 was a simple product. where there were few number of tables, where there were few number of fields. Everything was working fine. The performance was good, speed was good, everything was okay. Then came R3, there are a lot of functionalities available, there are a lot of tables, there are a lot of fields. So what was happening, let's say now I'll just write 2-3 tables here. Let's say there was BKPF and there were BSIG. Okay, and every table has 200-300 fields. Let's say 200-300 fields in BKPF and 200-300 fields in BSIG. Okay, so let's say, take an example, 200 fields, 300 fields. Now I want to generate a report. Open vendor line items. Okay, so normally which report we generate for this? FBL 1N. So let's say we are just, or maybe FBL 1 at that time. N is new GL accounting. Okay, so during this time, during R3, the transaction was FBL 1. So let's say you are trying to generate the report FBL 1 and you want to see the open vendor line items. And at that time, there were only two tables, BSIG and BKPF. There was no BSIK, there was no BSAK, there was no BSID, BSAD. Okay, those tables were not there. So every time when you generate the report using FBL 1, it was going to table BKPF and BSIG, which has 300 columns. And in FBL 1, normally how many columns you want? Just for example, how many columns are there in FBL 1 report? 5 to 8, maybe let's say 15 to 20. Okay, 15 to 20 columns. Now you are trying to generate a report which has only 15-20 columns from the table which has 200 columns. The problem was, if you try to generate this report from 200-300 columns, system was too slow because it was taking the time based on how many columns are there in the table. Okay, I'm explaining again. If you want 15-20 columns out of the table of 200-300 columns, system will not look at how many columns you want. It will take the time according to how many fields are there in the table, because the data was stored in the row-based form. In SAP ECC, the data is stored in the row-based form. Row-based form means the time taken by the report to execute depends upon how many columns are there in the report. How many columns are there in the table, right? And that is the reason SAP realized that my FBL 1 report is too slow. So what should we do? Let's create another table for only this 15-20 columns. That's why they created which tables? Any idea? They came up
with ACDOCA.
No. We are talking We are talking about this. Still, we are not in S/4HANA. So BSIK, BSAK.
Yeah.
Why this table is required? These tables are just the duplication. The information is already there in BSIK. Everything is available. Customer, open, or whether it is open or it is clear, everything is available. But still, we are not generating the report on FBL1. We are not generating the report from BSIG. We are generating the report from these tables. Why? Because if we ask this information from 300 columns report table, it will take more time compared to the table which has only 25 to 30 columns. Right? And that is the reason why SAP came up with these tables in between. Earlier, there were no, these tables were not there. BSIK, BSAK, BSID, there are six tables. These are called as index tables. These tables were not there in the original SAP system. Around, if you go back 15-20 years back, these tables were nowhere available. Why they were included? Just to increase the performance. How they increase the performance? By increasing the size of the database. So if you already have this data, you are again creating the same data in the same separate tables. So unnecessarily, you are increasing the memory size. It's like you have a same song available in your mobile, okay, and you don't want to listen to the full song, you want to listen only to the partial song, so you are creating another copy of that partial song, which is unnecessarily consuming more memory, right? So what is the solution now? How can we make sure that we don't unnecessarily keep on adding more number of tables? The solution is move from row-based data storage to column-based data storage. What is the benefit of column-based data storage, irrespective of how many columns you have in a report, in a table? Irrespective of how many columns you have in this table, it will still take the same time, even if there are 100 or 1000 columns available in this table. So it will not be based on the number of columns. When you were storing the data in the form of rows, the report was taking the time based on how many columns I have in that table. But when SAP S/4HANA, or to be precise, SAP HANA database stores the data in the form of columns, which means you don't need to worry about, you don't need any index tables anymore. So all those tables are gone in S/4HANA. We don't have BSIK, BSAK, BSID, these tables are gone. We only have main tables, and you can generate the reports directly from the main tables. Okay, so this is why row-based data storage was consuming a lot of time, and column-based data storage will not consume that much time. Any question on this? So SAP ECC was using, this is another challenge. So first challenge we discussed, that they were developed around 30 years back, and they were storing the data in the hard disk. Second challenge is the data was stored in row based form. Okay. And the benefit with SAP HANA is data is stored in column based form. Okay. That is one thing. Data is stored in the column based form, and column based data guarantees that whatever may be the number of columns, it will take the same time. Another important benefit of column based data storage is it compresses the data. I'll give you this another example now, compressing the data. So let's say in my table BKPF, if you are using SAP ECC system, BKPF table is consuming 10 GB of data. Okay, just for example, because this is ECC and ECC uses row-based data storage. Same data in S/4HANA with column-based data storage, same table, for example, BKPF, everything, all the lines will remain, nothing will go away. It will be around 2 to 3 GB. So there is around 70 to 80% reduction in the data size. Why? Because of compressed data. So now compression, you already know. If you want to send an Excel file which is of 10 GB or 10 MB file, and your company's policy doesn't allow to send the file which is more than 2 MB or 3 MB, so what you do? You zip that file. So zipping is what? Does it delete some content? Content is not deleted. Data is still that available in that table, but it is in the compressed form. Okay, so in the column-based data storage, the data is always stored in the compressed form. Okay, any question?
Hello.
Yes.
Is there any part of BPC involvement coming to S/4HANA Simple Finance actually? I mean, any parts of touch over there?
Sorry, can you come again?
Is there a business process consolidation slightly a part of S/4HANA Simple Finance basically?
So BPC is already the separate module. So even in SAP S/4HANA, there is a new technology or new terminology called as SAP IBP.
Okay, fine.
So that is something which is going to replace the BPC in future.
Okay.
We had a topic. We are also going to talk about that later on.
Okay, fine. Not a problem.
Okay, so now let me just take you to the slides once again, where we will be discussing about all these things. Okay, so we were talking about SAP HANA, and we already understood in our Excel sheet the challenges in traditional database. Just to summarize the same thing, so our traditional databases, they were designed to perform well on computer with limited RAM, okay, because the data was stored in the hard disk. The data model was complicated because there were a lot of tables. Why a lot of tables were required? I just gave you one simple example. We already have BSAK, but still we created BSIK, BSAK. Why we created that? Because the data was stored in the row-based form, and in the row-based form, the speed would be slow if there are more number of columns in the report, in the table, sorry. So that is the reason SAP has created a lot of different tables in SAP ECC. So there was redundancy of data. I'm talking about point number four, redundancy of data. What do you mean by redundancy? Redundancy is repetition. Same data again.
Duplicate, yeah.
Duplicate, yes. So I gave you the example. If you keep on saving same songs multiple times, it will unnecessarily increase the repetition. Need of aggregations. We'll talk about what are aggregations. Index we already discussed. So you can see this example. BSIS and BSAS are the index tables. High data footprint. Now, definitely, if you are saving same thing again and again, it will increase your memory size. And at the same time, ECC was not compressing the. Just to give a simple example, if you are using 10 GB of data, raw data, in your BKPF, and you are creating 10 different tables, let's say another GB of data, so total consumption is 14 GB. But now if you are going for SAP S/4HANA, first of all, those 4 GB is gone because you don't need those duplicates. And because you are using the data, because you are storing the data in the column-based form, it will compress the data. So out of 14 GB, you are coming to 2 or 3 GB of data. So you are saving a lot of money on memory. Row-based data storage, we already discussed. Because of all these points, the last two points, slower transaction processing and slower reporting. Now, the point here, what we are discussing from last half an hour is how performance will be increased, how performance will be improved with SAP HANA database. So performance will be improved because of in-memory computing, which means the data will be stored in RAM, simplified data model, less number of tables, no unnecessary data, no unnecessary tables in the system, removal of redundancies, so there is no repetition of data, no duplication of data, ultimately less data footprint, and data is stored in both the forms, rows as well as columns. So we are not saying the data is only stored in the column-based form in SAP S/4HANA, data is stored in both the forms, row plus column. I will tell you where exactly row-based data is also required, maybe later on when we see practical. So according to SAP, see this 1800 I am not saying, this is something which SAP is saying, if you implement SAP S/4HANA or if you just implement SAP HANA on your ECC system also, it will be around 1800 times faster processing, your transactions as well as reports. Okay, so if you ask me my practical experience, definitely not 1800 times, but definitely 4 to 5 times faster speed you will definitely see in each and every client. Okay, so for example, the report which was taking 5 minutes earlier, you will be able to see now it is running in 30 seconds or 40 seconds, but not in 1 or 2 seconds. Okay, but because again, there is a reason for that. So if you are going for SAP HANA database, SAP will tell you, you need to purchase this much of RAM. Okay, if you want 1800 times faster speed. And definitely customer will try to save that amount. He will say, no, 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 I don't want to purchase 1 TB, let's go with 500 GB, for example. Okay, so if you are deploying the RAM, which is recommended by SAP, definitely in that case, you may find this much performance in the speed. But if you are just going with the basics, basic RAM, okay, then you will be able to find around 5 to 10 times faster speed. Okay, so let me now just go through this one example, which is provided by SAP itself for one of the customers. Okay, this is very important. If you understand this slide, whatever we discussed till now, everything will be clarified once again. So you can see traditional database. So one of the customer who is already using SAP ECC system, in their traditional database, they were using around 593 GB of data. So their database size was 593 GB. Once they converted their database to SAP HANA, you can see second portion is HANA, not S/4HANA. So they just upgraded their database to HANA. Application is same, ECC. Okay, so you can see around 80% reduction. Around 80% reduction in the memory. Can you tell me how? This is all because of compression. Because column-based data storage is in the compressed form. Okay, so 593 GB of data, which was stored in the row-based form in traditional ECC system, on HANA database, it has reduced to 120 GB of data, which is around 80% of the reduction because of compression. So one-fifth, right? Then this customer has implemented SAP S/4HANA. Now same data, which was 120 GB, reduced to 42 GB. Now what is the reason? The reason is removal of duplicates. All those index tables, aggregate tables are removed, right? So customer is only left with 42.4 GB of data. Now the question is, if I have 593 GB of data in my ECC system, then definitely I have that much hard disk, around 600 GB of hard disk. How much RAM I need if I want to go for S/4HANA? Do I need 600 GB of RAM? Definitely not. Because your database size will come down to 42.4 GB. Okay, so it is kind of less than 90% reduction, right? So if you are having 600 GB of hard disk, you only need 50 GB of RAM. That too you can save if you go to the last one, actual data. So even you don't need 42.4 GB of RAM, even 10 GB of RAM is sufficient. Why? Because this 42.4 GB of data is for all the years. So let's say if you have 10 years of data, out of that 10 years of data, do you want to store all that data into RAM? Not required. You can only keep last 2 years of data in RAM and all remaining data in the hard disk. So SAP HANA is not saying you cannot store the data in hard disk. It is saying you, in addition to hard disk, you can store the data in RAM. So out of 42.4 GB of total data, only 8.4 GB of data is relevant to previous 2 years. All other data is relevant to historical information. So what you can do is you can move the historical data into hard disk and only keep important data of last 2 years into the RAM. So just to summarize this, if you have around 600 GB of total data in your current system, you only need around 10 GB of RAM to store that data. Okay, you got this point now?
Yeah, Gaurav.
Yes, Sandeep.
Yes. So here on HANA, when we are having the HANA database, that time we have 118 GB of data, right? But after implementing S/4HANA, how it is coming down to 42 GB? Because already we have compressed the data and removed the like repetitive data. So again, no, how it is coming down?
See, where you remove the data. If you are on traditional database, you have this BSIS, BSAS, BSIK, BSAK. If you just upgrade your database to HANA, will it remove all those tables?
I hope so.
No, if you are just going for SAP HANA database, it will not add any new table, it will not remove any old tables. It will just convert row based to column based, and it will just convert hard disk to memory. It will not delete any of the tables.
Okay.
So what is happening? See, 600 GB of data, which is stored in the hard disk in the row based form, right? Now, when you go to SAP HANA database, there will be two points. One is you will be storing the data in RAM, and second is the data will be stored in the column based form with compression. And that is the reason from 600 GB, it will come down to 120 GB. Okay, but the tables like ACDoc, the old tables like Faggle FlexP, BSIS, they will not remove when you upgrade to HANA database. They will only go away when you upgrade to S4HANA application.
Okay.
Clear?
Yes, sir.